Its Deputy Vice President for Strategy, Andrei Gaidamaka, joins us now. Andrei Gaidamaka, welcome to First Look here on Bloomberg, live from Hong Kong. Just what do you hope to achieve from this listing in Hong Kong?
We hope to attract new investor base from Asia, and we would like to fund with Asian money, we would like to fund Asian projects. Today, Lukoil, which we also posted, apart from very good financial results that we just posted, we posted a double-digit increase in our deliveries of natural gas that we produce in Uzbekistan, which a significant portion of it actually goes to China. And this is the business that we are very excited about, and we believe that there is very high demand for natural gas in China. And today, Lukoil is one of the very few companies that are capable of supplying pipeline gas to China at significant scale.
Now,
we have plans to...
Sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. You're already listed in London. You're already listed in Moscow. Is that not enough for you? Is what we're seeing with this listing in Hong Kong nothing more than a very expensive marketing exercise?
Well, it is. Hong Kong is a gateway to the Chinese financial market these days, and we do believe that China has very significant reserves, a very significant pension money that is increasingly available for investing in outside of the country assets. And we do believe that with a growing Asian business and the $3.8 billion record earnings that we just generated and showed, and $5.3 billion of EBITDA, and the multiples that are one-third, financial multiples that are one-third of other Asian companies, we do believe that we can attract better investment base or more investor base here and offer better investment opportunity for Asian money.
Now, you may buy back an additional $2 to $3 billion of your own shares. Have you got a time scale for that?
Well, this is something that I think will be announced in a very short time frame, but it definitely will happen this year.
How confident are you of actually gaining access to the Shanghai Stock Exchange? Because that has been a goal of many international companies for many years, and many international companies are continually blocked. Do you see movement there?
Yes, there is some movement on that front, but I think that right now Hong Kong Stock Exchange is has way more certain path to achieving listing here and achieving exposure to the Asian market. Shanghai is a bit more complex.
You've previously said that you might actually borrow in the Chinese currency, the yuan. Are you still thinking on those lines? What advantages might that give you?
No, currently we didn't say that we would borrow in yuan. What we are saying is that we would like to attract equity investors in China, and that way to diversify our investor base somewhat, because right now it's predominantly Western investor base, actually with very small involvement even of Russian money. And we are working on a significant expansion of Russian investor base as well, but we believe that there is a very good opportunity to attract Asian money in Hong Kong now.
And what sort of direct investment might you want to make in China? You have none at the moment. Is that the ultimate goal?
Well, the ultimate goal is for us to continue investing in Central Asian countries where we operate very actively. We are about number three or four operator in Kazakhstan, and we are a distant number one private company in Uzbekistan. There is, of course, Uzbek Neftigaz, which is a state monopoly. They have fantastic work experience and reserves and production and so forth. But Lukoil is, again, number one private operator in Uzbekistan, and we are number three private operator in Kazakhstan. So these are the areas where we want to invest more, and this is absolutely sort of Asian and Chinese demand-driven areas.
Andrei Gaidamaka, Deputy Vice President of Strategic Development at Lukoil. We're grateful to you. Thanks for joining us live on Bloomberg today.